Monday that the CIA and the Mossad... What if I tweeted one day that the CIA and the Mossad were going to attempt to frame me and then torture me to death? And then 4 hours after that tweet, I was found dead in an ocean. What would you think? You think that it was just an accident, that the timing of my tweet was suspicious and then I naturally drowned? I'm asking you that question for a reason. I'm asking you because it's actually happened to somebody, and this story that I read completely sent a shiver up my spine. I think that it will send one up yours as well. A lot of people were sending me information claiming, get this, and I'm going to be clear, this sounded to me like a conspiracy theory, that Jeffrey Epstein was a part of our intelligence agencies, right? That he was actually operating a blackmail ring. And this is the reason why nobody would prosecute him, because he was a protected CIA asset, right? So the idea is that Jeffrey Epstein would get very powerful people to attend his parties, who would bring them out on the Lolita Express, would bring him to his island in the Caribbean. Remember, he somehow had enough money to purchase an entire island, Little St. James. And he would get them to sleep with women, maybe unbeknownst to them that these women were very young, and then he'd have blackmail. He'd record the acts, and then suddenly he had control over people all around the world. Because, hey, if you don't do what we say, we're going to show this video of you sleeping with a 14-year-old. That sounds crazy, right? And by the way, this conspiracy theory of him operating a blackmail ring didn't come from nowhere. Actually, it came from somewhere. It came from Alexander Acosta, being just one individual that leaned into this conspiracy theory. He was a former U.S. attorney who was also selected by President Trump to be the Labor Secretary of the United States. And throughout his confirmation hearings, a lot of people in the press were saying, this guy allowed Jeffrey Epstein to get off scot-free. And so throughout his interviews with the Trump administration, he was asked about that. And he asked the question, is the Epstein case going to cause a problem? He explained breezily, apparently, that back in the day, he had had just one meeting on the Epstein case. He'd cut the non-prosecution deal with one of Epstein's attorneys because he, Alexander Acosta, had been told to back off, that Epstein was above his pay grade. He said, quote, I was told Epstein belonged to intelligence and to leave it alone, he told interviewers in the Trump transition. So that obviously makes people believe that it's true, that he, Alexander Acosta, was simply told, hey, you gotta let this guy go, he's an asset. And that would sort of make sense as to why he kept slipping through the cracks of the legal system. But there's more stuff that is the reason that people believe that this is all true. In case you missed this in the news, Jeffrey Epstein, and by the way, you can find these articles in NBC News, The Washington Post. This is not stuff that I'm finding on some sort of conspiracy website. This is known in the mainstream media that all of this is true. So Jeffrey Epstein used a foreign passport with a fake name to enter several countries in the 1980s, including the United Kingdom, Spain, and Saudi Arabia. That is weird. The passport contained a photo of Epstein with a different name and listed his place of residence as Saudi Arabia. That's according to federal prosecutors. Now, how bizarre is that? It's a fake name which lists his residence in Saudi Arabia. Who would have the power to issue a fake passport to Jeffrey Epstein? It's a fact that he had a fake passport. It's a fact that he used that fake passport to enter different countries. It is a fact that nobody can explain how he was wealthy enough to purchase an island. It is a fact that he kept slipping through the legal system. It is a fact that Alexander Acosta said that he was told to let him go. Who would have that much power? Then, of course, was the strange case of Ghislaine Maxwell and her father. Her father died under mysterious circumstances. This is from a Washington Post article in 1991. The father's name was Robert Maxwell. The article says, Maxwell, whose body was recovered from the Atlantic Ocean off the Canary Islands last Tuesday after he disappeared from his yacht, was buried late this afternoon in Judaism's most prestigious spot, the cemetery of Jerusalem's Mount of Olives, facing the Western Wall. His funeral service in Jerusalem's Hall of the People was attended by a host of Israeli politicians, led by Prime Minister Shamir and President Herzog. Jeffrey Epstein was linked to the Mossad and the CIA, and that he was an asset. And what added to that theory, I should say, because I cannot confirm this, I don't want you to walk away and say, can't confirm this is true, was that Ghislaine Maxwell's father had a lot of power in Israel. I mean, how powerful a person you have to be to get both the president and the prime minister to attend your funeral. And he also died in mysterious circumstances. What if I tweeted?